everyone, and welcome to this tutorial. In this video, we're going to have a look at how to create a similar page with sticky overlapping sections, a sticky header, and a sticky footer that is revealed once you scroll till the very end of the page. To create such a layout, we're going to need to use Elementor Pro, because unfortunately, sticky functionality is not available for the free version of Elementor Page Builder. But before we start, a quick reminder that on Elementor Marketplace by TemplateMonster, you can download hundreds of WordPress themes and page templates built with Elementor Page Builder. Choose from a dozen of Elementor add-ons and get Monstroid too, the best multi-purpose modular Elementor WordPress theme, which allows you to customize headers and footers for your website and provides thousands of ready-made pages and sections, and also a dozen of Elementor add-ons, all in one package. If you're interested, check out the links in the description. In case you need to buy WordPress themes and plugins in bulk, check out One by TemplateMonster. One is a subscription service that offers over 10,000 products for website building. For only $19 per month, you can download an unlimited number of products and unlimited number of times and use them for an unlimited number of projects. Check out the link to One subscription by TemplateMonster in the description under this video. And now let's proceed to the tutorial. This is what we're starting with. We have a header, which is not sticky for now. We have three sections and a footer. I'm going to walk you through the entire process step by step. And we're going to start with this layout. I have already pre-made a header using Elementor Pro and also a footer. But usually when you start editing your pages on the default page layout, not on the Elementor canvas, but on default page layout, you're going to have a title also visible underneath your header. And for this particular case, we do not want to have this title here. So you can enable the hide title option. It might be that this is not going to work for your theme, because in some themes, headers have different classes. It is pretty easy to fix. Just go to the preview of your page. And here we're going to need to access the inspector. You can either right-click and choose inspect, or you could also use hotkeys, which is F12 for Windows and Command Options I for Mac. And here, let's choose this icon here. And we need to select the header. And this is how we're going to see a class. In my case, it is called Page Title. What I need to do here is to select it, copy it, and then jump to the WordPress dashboard. In the dashboard, go to Elementor Settings, and then in the Style tab, and in the Page Title Selector field, insert the class you have copied after the dot. Now this all should work great. Let's test it. Here we go. Now our title is hidden. And what I want to do here is to grab this section and move it so it is underneath the header. The minimum height that I have set to the header was 70 pixels. So I'm going to try and insert the negative margin here of minus 140 pixels. So this is how the top of the section matches the top of the header. So this is done. Now we have a navigator here, and if you are not using navigator, I totally recommend you to start using it, because it's a really convenient tool, and for some workflows it is absolutely necessary to use it, because it's a huge time saver. Let's see how we can open a navigator. The first option is to go and click on this icon here. You can also close it the same way. Another way is to right click anywhere on your page and choose navigator. First of all, let's see how we can benefit from using a navigator. In our case, if I want to change the order of my sections, I can simply drag the sections here in the navigator, so I don't have to drag the actual sections on my page. I simply can drag them over here. So it works pretty much the same way as, let's say, layers in Photoshop. We can also rename any section and any element you have inside your sections. And for us, it will be really helpful that we can access all the settings of this section from here, because once we're going to make them sticky and once we're going to make them overlap, this is going to be pretty tricky to access the settings for certain sections or certain elements on the section. So once we're all set, let's work on the actual sections and let's try and make them sticky. I would start with the first section. And first of all, if you're working on the default layout, also make sure that you have enabled the stretch section option, because if you don't, it's going to look like this. It's not going to take up the entire width of the page. But what you want is the section that is fully stretched to the entire width of your page. Also, to make sure that your section takes up all the height of your page, set the height of the section to fit to screen. Now let's go to the Advanced tab, and in the Motion Effects, in Elementor Pro, you have the Sticky option, and we need to choose the top option here. This is what happens, and here, as you can see, I scroll down, but all I can see in my viewport is this section, because it takes up all the width and all the height of my page, and now this is the only thing that I can see in my viewport. We're pretty much done with the Motion Effects. Here, let's see what we can do with the Z-index. So Z-index is essentially the thing that allows you to order your sections on the page from top to bottom. The items with the higher Z-index will be on top of the other items with the lower Z-index. So let's start with 5 here. It means that if I go to the section number 2, here it is, you can see this bounding box sliding up, but we don't see the actual section because its Z-index is lower, by default it's 0, now it is lower than the Z-index of the first section. So let's just set a higher Z-index, let's set 6, even if we say 6, it is gonna already be on top of the first section. So for now it looks something like that. We have achieved the sticky overlapping effect, and let's proceed doing that. We're still in the settings of the second section. So Z-index is set in the Motion Effects. Again, sticky to top. Now the third section, go to Advanced, and we need to set the Z-index that is higher than the Z-indexes of the first two sections, which will be, in our case, 7. You can pick your own values depending on how many elements you have and how you want to arrange and organize them. These are just my values, and you don't have to use the same ones. So there it is. This is what it looks like on the full screen. So this all looks pretty nice, but we have no header right now at the moment. How can we fix that? First, we need to get back to the WordPress dashboard and go to the Theme Builder. It is under Templates, Theme Builder, and here we can access all of the theme parts that we have, including headers, footers, single page templates, and archive page templates. Header sticky, edit with Elementor. First of all, we're going to make it sticky too, so it stays at the top of the page as we scroll down. And we're also going to change its Z-index, so it stays on top of our elements on the page. So let's select this section, go to Advanced, and in the Z-index, we need to set the value that is higher than the highest Z-index that our elements on the page have. In our case, it was 7. Let's set it to 10, just in case. So it is the highest value for sure. Then Motion Effects, and I'm also going to make it sticky to the top and update. Now if we go to the preview and refresh the page, this is what we see. As we scroll down, the header stays at the top of the page, and it also follows us, and it is on top of all the other sections on the page. This is done, but how can we achieve that hidden footer type of effect? Let's now get back to the Theme Builder and go to Footer Sticky, Edit with Elementor. And we're going to see what settings we can adjust there to make the footer sticky too. Yes, we're actually going to make it sticky, but it's going to be sticky according to the bottom of the page. This is our footer. You can customize it the way you like, but don't make it too huge because it's not going to look too good on this type of layout. Now let's select this section in advanced. The Z index should be somewhere in between the Z index of the second card on our page and the third card. So it is on top of the second card, so it covers it, but the third card is on top of it. So once we scroll down to the end of the page, the third card will reveal our footer. So I hope it makes sense. And now let's try and set it to 7 in the motion effects tab. It is sticky to bottom. But we also don't want to see the second card peeking out there somewhere. So let's set the background color for the footer so it is not transparent. But if we do just that, this is what is going to happen. This footer is going to stay in the viewport the entire time. And the third card is going to cover it and then reveal it again. But what we don't want is this footer being visible while we're scrolling past these two first sections. This is an easy fix. Let's see what we can do. First off, while in the advanced tab, in the motion effects tab, we want this footer to be hidden or to be not visible while we are somewhere around two first sections. And we may allow it to, and we can allow it to appear once it is behind the third section and we cannot see it anymore. Let's enable scrolling effects and enable the transparency option. But these are the values that worked for me. Fade in, I set 10 as a value for the level, and I moved the sliders this way, that this slider stays on 100%, and the position of this slider will depend on the length of your page, so you try and figure out the values yourself. For my layout, it worked somewhere around 55%. This is what it's gonna look like. You're not gonna see how this effect works. You won't be able to see it in action here in the editor while we're editing the footer. Another important thing here is to set effects relative to entire page. We don't see the footer anymore. This is where you could use the navigator if you wanted to access the settings again. So this is pretty much it. I'm done with the settings. Here it means that this footer is gonna be fully transparent, is gonna be fully not visible somewhere around 55% of my entire page. And it is gonna appear once we reach, it is gonna start to appear. Once we reach 55% and it is going to be fully transparent around the very end of the page. This is what I figured out playing around with the values. You could try your own values and see how it works. Before we update, as you remember, we have moved our top section underneath the header, so we had to add the negative margin. Now, in order to put everything in place and have no extra space in between our footer and our third section, we need to add the margin, negative margin again, and this time it will be minus 70, like that, and click update. And if we go to the preview, we're going to see that header is staying on top, cards overlap each other, and we don't see the footer, and once we reach the third section, and once we scroll down, and we see that our footer is being revealed. This is what it looks like. And this is the result that was our goal that we were going to achieve. And we're pretty much done with this tutorial. If you liked it, leave us your thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and leave your ideas for the future tutorials. Also, don't forget to check out Monstroid 2 on TemplateMonster.com and one subscription by TemplateMonster, which offers you over 10,000 products for website building at only $19 per month. And if you're lucky, you can even get the subscription at a discount. So I hope you found this tutorial useful. Thank you for watching. See you in another video.